I electric potential and no electric potential. So this B is a negative charge and A is the positive charge. So B is a low electric potential, and when electricity will be flow, it will be flow from negative charge particles to the positive charge particles, means from B to A. And what is the difference between this point A and B? It's called the electrical potential between them. Okay, getting it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And yes.
Your work has done to be done. Work has to be done. The electric field to take a positive charge from a point of lower potential to a point of higher potential. What happens there? Electric field to take a positive charge from lower potential to the higher potential. Now, potential difference of a cell. We have to speak about the cell. Cell means what? Do you know cell? The cell you have seen, this word in biology cell. Will tell me definition of cell? Anybody knows? You have learned? Don't know? Cell is a structural and functional. No? Not getting idea? Yes? Diksha?
Yes, sir. The cell is a structural and functional unit of a body.
Yes. Cell is structural and...
Sir, and fundamental also.
Yeah, that only. So, this is a meaning, this is a definition of cell. But when we are speaking about this cell, okay, about this electricity, that time it is a small room. Okay, it is a one small room here. We are taking this meaning of it. The difference in the potential between the positive and negative terminals of a cell is a potential difference of that cell. This what? Suppose this is a cell. Cell means this is a box or small room. Okay. And here, suppose this is a positive charge, this is a negative charge, and between this, what is the difference between it? That is the potential difference of that cell. Okay. Now, here, this depends on the motion of electrons. This depends on the motion of electrons. And if this potential difference is sets the in the motion of electrons in the result flow of electricity through a conducting wire, and due to that reason, we can understand there is a, they are connected, these two this positive and negative charge, or our electricity conductive wire, we know it's connected here to at different points. Suppose this is a source of electricity, and this is suppose some appliances that we are using. So from this point we have to reach. So here, what is the difference between it? That is the potential difference of cell. And here we have to speak about related to point A and B. Then we are going to take the potential difference between point A and B is work upon total charge transferred. This work, how much work done by that conductor or that object upon the total charge, how much transferred in it. So we'll get the potential difference unit is their volt. How that? 1 joule per second. Because work we are measuring in joule and charge Q. Q we are measuring in coulomb. Remember, C for coulomb, J for joule. So we'll get 1 joule upon coulomb. Got it, everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Any difficulty? Now here you can see the free electrons. Here nucleus electrons, weakly attached outermost electrons, and free electrons move freely from atom to atom. Yesterday only I spoken about it. These electrons are just vibrating on their place, and they are transferring their energy to another. This one will be transferred like this, and then they will pass this continuously, okay, until the end of that circuit. Okay, and nucleus is very important. We know nucleus is very important because without nucleus, it will not become a their cell. And nucleus is always like this, and around it, we know their protons and neutrons are present in it. Okay? Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now here you can see weakly attached outermost means what happened there? those are outermost electrons. Suppose this cell is here and these electrons are there, they are closer. But this is the outermost, they are away from the nucleus, then they are weakly attached to it. Okay. And these electrons are always, we know that those are very closer, they are attract stronger than the, those are further than it. Now one scientist name is given there, Volta, is a Italian scientist, Alessandro Volta. He has constructed the first electric cell, and is the honor of his name, this is invention, this unit is named as the volt. Okay, a very small values of potential difference are expressed in the following units: 1 millivolt, 1 mV.
Sir, your voice is not coming.
Now coming?
Yes, it is coming.
Sir, it is coming.
Okay. So 1 millivolt is equal to 10⁻³ volt. Okay. 10⁻³ volt. 1 micro. Micro means -6. 10⁻⁶. Kilowatt. We know kilovolt 10⁻³, and megavolt 10⁻⁶. See, this difference is very important, because sometimes this is given like this in millivolt, or sometimes kilovolt. We have to convert into the microvolt or megavolt. So now free electrons. What is in the free electrons? What is in the now free part we have learned. So will tell me about the free electrons.
Sir, can I?
Yeah.
Weakly bounded to the nucleus.
Weakly bounded to the
nucleus.
Good. Any other one? Yes, Sarthak.
The electrons which are very weakly bound to the nucleus, these electrons are called as the free electrons.
Now see there, we are speaking about the free electrons. So when we are speaking about electrons, so this is the nucleus, these are the cells. Okay. So what happens? Those are weakly attached to the nucleus. That electrons are free. Those are weakly attached to the nucleus, they are free electrons, and it's easy to transfer from one place to another place. But those are strongly attached to the nucleus, it's their little heavy, or we require their more energy to do the movement. So due to that, every atom of a metallic conductor has one or more outermost electrons which are very weakly bound to the nucleus, and these are called free electrons. So here in this figure 3.3, you can see these electrons. Okay, this metal wire and these electrons are there. This metal wire, what happened? These free electrons are randomly, they can move, because they are not strongly attached to the this nucleus. And when we are speaking about the metal wire, that time with the, when we are not passing the electricity through it, at that time these electrons will present in the form of like this free electrons anywhere. But at once we joined it to the circuit, that time what happened, or the electrical cell, that time these all electrons are falling in one line, and they flow from one straight direction, this from negative to the positive direction. Getting it? Means until teacher is absent in class, students are there free. Correct? And when teacher will be entered, then all students will be sitting in line, sit on their benches like this. Correct? No? This example is suitable for
yes,
you. Yeah. So this is also cell. Yeah. Until the electrical cell, until the external their electricity not join it, or not current is joined to it, or this point to negative ions not joined to this conducting wire, then they are free. But at once join and we switch on the button, immediately these free electrons will be move from negative to the positive direction. And they will be there in straight line. It will be in straight line. But see here, while they are flowing like this, Here it's shown that it's flowing. But actually what happened, these electrons giving its energy to these electrons. This is, then it will be vibrate, it will be give its energy to this. And like this, current is flowing. Okay? Getting it? Yes or no? And this?
Yes, sir.
This sentence, keep in mind, the free electrons in a conductor are the carriers of negative charge. Free electrons in the conductors are the carriers of negative charge. Eka ek negative charge vahun nenare carrier mal vaatu gadi kalala kalate.
Yes sir.
Yeah, yes or no? Okay.
Yes sir.
Now we'll see here current flowing through a wire. Okay, so just I told already whatever given in this point, but then also I'm going to read it. Okay, so as shown in the figure 3.4a, this, if a conducting wire is not connected to a cell, its free electrons move randomly in all direction in the space between the atoms. Why it can flow? Because they are random. Here space between it, if you see, okay, and already they are not connected to the wire. Due to that reason they can randomly move. Okay. And when we connect the ends of the wires to the two terminals of a cell, electric force acts on the electrons, being negative charge, they start moving from the negative potential, means lower potential, to positive, means higher potential, and as shown in the figure 3.4b. Due to the flow of these electrons, current starts to flow through the wire. Okay. So this motion of electrons is irregular, but there is a definite non-zero value of their average velocity. It's irregular. It's not regular, but their average velocity is non-zero. It's not zero. Okay, now we have to see very important topic, that is the electric current, and our lesson name is also there same. Okay, so electric current. What is meant by current? Current, we know we are denoting by letter I. So I told already, flow of charges in the conducting wire in per unit time, that is called the current. So I is denoted for the current, Q is denoted for the charge, and T for the time. So an electric current is the flow of electrons through a conductor. What is the definition? Very simple. Electric current is the flow of electrons through a conductor. And when we are speaking about the quantitatively or in the term of mathematics, then we can say that current is defined as the charge passing through a conductor in unit time. And in the here you'll get current I is equal to Q upon T. So if charge Q is flowing through cross section of a conductor in time T, then this cross section is their particular area. About that we are speaking. The current I is equal to Q upon T. Got it, student? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's easy, no? Is it easy?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So see here, the unit of charge in the SI unit, already I told this coulomb is measured in the charge is measured in the coulomb, and time we know measured in the second. So we'll get the coulomb per second. And 1 coulomb per second is equal to 1 ampere, is equal to 1 ampere. And one, the charge of 1 electron, remember this is a value, the charge of 1 electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Okay, here it's a if you see the spellings, it's coulomb. Okay, so 1 ampere current is said to be flow in a conductor. This definition also very important. No need to remember the definition, only remember this given here in the form of mathematical. Current I is measured in the ampere, and it's here coulomb per second. So flow in conductor, if 1 coulomb charge flows through it every second, that is the 1 ampere. And this ampere also one scientist name that we are going to see here. He was one French mathematician and scientist. Yesterday there are so many things, experiments about his electricity, and then he got that unit, and he has invented, due to that reason, this unit called as the ampere. Okay, it's recognition of his work. If we will do good work, then people will be recognize it and they will remember us. So we should also do good work for our society, not for only ourselves. Okay. So very small values, like as we have seen, 1 milliampere about to hold also we have seen there, 10^-3 was there. And here 1 milliampere is equal to 10^-3 ampere, 1 microampere is equal to 10^-6 ampere. Okay. Here one box is given, even though electrons move from a negative end to positive end, conventionally the direction of current flow is taken be opposite to the direction of flow of electrons, that is from the positive end to the negative end. Means we know that electrons are flowing from negative to the positive, negative to the positive, then also the flow of electrons, we are speaking in the direction of their positive to the negative of cell. Means if you see here the cell, electrons flowing from negative to positive, but that charge will be from positive to the negative. Getting it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
No.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Now see here, what is given in the problem? A current of 0.4 ampere. Current of 0.4 ampere. This current denoted by letter I, so you will get here first 0.4 ampere. Flows through a conductor for 5 minutes. Time is given 5 minutes. Yes, Sarthak, any question is there?
No, sir, by mistake.
Okay, okay. 5 minutes means this we have to convert into the second. So we know 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Yes, Parthrathi?
Yes, sir. Which is the sign called?
For what?
Sir, this one sign.
What is sign?
Symbol.
Symbol A. A for ampere. These symbols we'll get. We're having in next topic. Okay, I've said it. Don't worry. Now, a conductor for 5 minutes means here we have to take time, minute, given in minutes, we have to convert it to the seconds, it will be there 300 seconds. How much charge will have passed through the conductor? Charge means we have to find here Q. So see.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, that sign not, do you know sign second point one?
Second point one, I am not getting what do you want to say, please, you can repeat.
Sir, that do you know box? Second is there now, micro ampere.
Yeah, yeah, this.
So that is sign of micro?
Yeah, yeah, this is a sign for micro. Okay, and this is for milli.
Okay, sir.
Okay, this is a micro, always we are using as a micro, okay? Now, here see, I is given 0.4, T is we have converted into the second, sits here, 300 seconds, then we have to find the Q. So we know the formula I is equal to Q upon T. But here given the value of I, so you can write here 0.4. Q, it's given there, not given. Time is given 300. So now we have to find the value of Q. Q is equal to 300 multiplied by 0.4. Multiply, what you get, now we know here, after decimal point, how many digits? 1 digit. So this 0 we can cancel, then 30 into 4, what will get here? 120 coulomb. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, any doubt now?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. So, yeah.